Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to the channel. It is so lovely to see you back. So in this video, I'll show you how to do a scene extension like this. And we're going to do this inside of Fusion, so it is pretty easy. It's also a lockdown shot, so it is a bit easier to do, but this is just the first of this kind of tutorial, so I guess that'll be just fine. So without further ado, let's go to Fusion and let's begin.
Okay, before we go to Fusion, we'll start up in Davinci Resolve, and this is the clip we are going to work with. It's just a locked off shot. And one of the things I like about this technique is that we can take this boring location and make it look like something quite unique and way more cool than it actually is. So in Fusion, we have here, of course, our media in and our media out. And then I have here a picture, and I have a statue, which I have used a polygon for, and I just did a mask. You can do a use a PNG, of course, if you want to do that. And then I have the exact same thing here with the mushrooms. So pretty simple. So let's get right to that. So first off, let's take down a merge node, and again, push shift and let it into the composition here. And then we'll connect our layer here. And now we have a problem, because this mountain layer are now on top of everything and we can't really see what's going on. So I have a little trick here. So first up, let's take in a color corrector. And then we'll just drag an input into the color corrector, and we'll select the color corrector, and let's go in and let's take all the saturation out of the picture here. Okay. And let's just go up and change from colors to levels, and we'll just drag the dark down here a bit. Oh, one sec, I need to go back to the colors here, and again, the saturation needs to be all the way down here. There we are. Okay, back to the levels, and I'll just continue to make this more black and white-ish. So I'll just drag down the highlights here, and that's maybe it's good enough. Let's try. So again, here I'm going to drag our output and I'll pipe it into the blue merge here, and as you see, nothing is happening. So now I'm going to connect in the mountains here, and nothing is happening. It looks like the same. What an idiot you are. Let's change that. Let's go into the merge node, going to this tab here, and in the channels we're going to change it from alpha into lumens. And here we have the mountain picture, and let's see here, and then we could add in a transform node. Let's go. Again, holding shift, dragging it down to the line and letting go when it turns blue, and it will be connected. Okay, so let's go into the output here and have that on screen too. And then let's select the transform node, and then I'll just scale the image a bit here. Try to make it look good. Okay, maybe a little something like so, and then let's move it up a bit. There we go. So I like to have this this like this building down in the corner. I want to have that in, so I'll just size it down a bit. Something like that. Not too bad. Okay. Let's just zoom in a bit here and let's have a look at that. And as you see, it actually looks pretty decent already. So this is a way or a technique you can use if you don't want to do a lot of rotoscoping and you want to put in a different background. So just a little tip here. So let's continue with the next thing we need to add. That is our statue. So first off, I'm going to drag in a merge 2 node. And again, with that connected, I will pipe this in as my foreground. And let's just rearrange a bit here. Okay, and that's way too big and doesn't look that good. So let's change that. So we'll just add in another transform node, and again, shift and let go, and let go when the line becomes blue. There we go. And then let's size this down a tad. And that's always too much. So a little more. Yeah. Let's see if that's good enough. And then we're going to put that out here in the corner as a statue of some sort. Okay. And then again, I'm just going to put in a, let's remove that, put in another merge. Again, shift and let it go when the line turns blue. Damn. There we go. Okay, and again, I'm going to add this in as a foreground. Here we have some mushrooms. And again, I am just going to add in a transform node. And doing the exact same thing again. And then we're just going to size these mushrooms down, otherwise they'll be too big and too strange. Okay, and let's see. Something like that. Okay, and we'll just put them here. I'll just move the output a bit. Okay, so let's see what we can do about this as well. Oops. Okay, so let's make this look a little bit nicer as well. And then I'll just add in a blur here, and again, I'm going to add in the blur in between or before I have my two elements in the front of the frame. So again, I'll see if I can add that in, just like so. Okay, and then I'll just go to the inspector here, and I'm going to change it into Gaussian blur, and then I am just going to blur just a tad, and then I'll just hit the keyframe, and then I'm just going to go some frames forward, something like so, and then I'm just going to change and make it in focus. So that's the first thing we need to do. Okay, and then I'll need to rearrange a bit here. Okay, and then I'll add in another blur in here. Actually, let me add it in two, but that's fine. I'll use the third blur in a sec. So I'm going to add this in between the statue and the transform node. And again, I'll change to Gaussian blur. And we'll go into, again, the keyframes. I'll set in a keyframe. And let's say I want it to be when we are here in the time, I want this to be out of focus. And then we'll just set in a beginning keyframe, which will be the beginning of the clip. And here I want it to be in focus. So now we'll have like this. Eventually we will have like a rack focus shift in the focus. So let's just do the last one. We'll do the exact same thing here. Again, adding in the blur in between the mushrooms and the transform node. And we're going to do the same thing. We're going to change the Let's change the blur first. I'll add in a keyframe. And then I'll just go in to where the keyframe needs to be, or where it needs to be out of focus, something like that. Okay. Okay, and then let's have a look at what we did here. And let's just set in the keyframe. Okay, and there we go. Okay, and something like this, I think, looks better. So let's keep it like that. Okay. And here we have the rack focus shift. And again, when I didn't view it here, the shift is fine, but the mushrooms looks a bit mushy. So we'll go back to Fusion and I'll take the transform node, and I'm just going to, I think I'll move the mushrooms out a bit or down a bit here. And I'm also going to flip the layer a bit, and let's move it a bit out of the frame here. Something like that. So here we have the final resolve. And then of course the trick would be to do a lot of grading or do stylized grading if you want to make them look a little bit better. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.